I'm Caterina Spinaris with Desert Waters Correctional Outreach. Today I'll share with you in a nutshell what Desert Waters does to pursue correctional staff wellness, how we do it, and why we do it. Quite simply, correctional staff wellness is a mission-critical issue. Correctional staff grapple with corrections fatigue on an ongoing basis. Corrections fatigue is a term I originated in the year 2000. Because of it, a correctional staff member may look good on the outside, may look like they've got everything under control, but on the inside, they may be struggling or even falling apart. So that's why we want to pursue correctional staff wellness. And to give you an idea of what that may look like, here are some actual quotes by correctional staff from across the country. I don't trust anybody. Nobody cares. I'm miserable. I treat my children like inmates. I'm considering suicide. I can't relax. I'm afraid to ask for help, which means I'm ashamed to ask for help. What are some of the work stressors that contribute to correctional fatigue? Here are the three major categories. Operational stressors are the technical aspects of the job, such as equipment issues, staffing issues, shift work, mandatory overtime. Organizational stressors are about the people aspects of the job, such as division and feuding amongst different teams or ranks or groups of staff. It could be personality clashes, it could be certain policies and procedures. And traumatic stressors are about violence, injury, and death, exposure to those. And it could be direct exposure, like people are witnessing those events in real time, or it can be indirect exposure, where they read about the event after the incident was over, the view of video, or they hear about it from other staff. Because of the impact of these work stressors, if nothing is done to resolve them, people start changing in negative ways, such as they may be chronically tense and hypervigilant, cynical about everything, irritable, stressing, intimidating, controlling, reclusive, want to stay away from people. They may have health and functioning changes, such as issues with depression and post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, anxiety, substance abuse. There may be family conflict issues, suicidal thinking or acting, homicidal thinking or behaviors. And they may also show changes that are negative in their beliefs and behavior, such as being in denial about what's going on, avoiding soft emotions, such as sadness or tenderness, dehumanizing others, especially offenders, overgeneralizing from one to all. If one is bad, all are bad, and coping by looking the other way instead of holding people accountable. As a result of having staff changes happen, if enough staff are affected in that way, then the whole workforce culture reflects the same traits. So we have machismo, acting super tough, shaming people who ask for help, the John Wayne syndrome of independence, aggression, having no compassion for others, and just all staff saying, I'm good, when asked how they're doing, when inside they may not be doing well at all. And as a result of all those issues, the agency starts getting impacted with high sick leave use, low morale, where staff do not want to be there, high turnover, policy violations, employee misconduct, and impaired work performance. And these are outcomes of corrections fatigue, but also they produce more corrections fatigue in people around those individuals who witness those things. They have to deal with them. Like low morale becomes contagious, like a bad virus, and everybody's dragged down. So causes and effects become a circular snowball situation. Here's our model pulled together of how corrections fatigue happens as a process over time, like with those three groups of work stressors, the operational, organizational, traumatic, feeding into the life of individuals, impacting them and resulting in the negative personality changes, declined health and functioning, unhealthy core beliefs and behaviors individually. And then when enough people have those issues going on in their lives and at work, then the whole workforce culture basically reeks of the same thing, and it's a fatigued culture, unhealthy. In order to design materials to address those issues to prevent as much as possible and to counter GORGS fatigue when set in. We have conduct research. So we have looked at disorders such as PTSD, severe depression, generalized anxiety, alcohol abuse, and suicidal thinking. And you can see in this on this graph that custody staff have the highest rates and the non-custody staff in facilities the next highest, and then the lowest are probation and parole. And in another study, we have found that the highest was security staff, the lowest were executive staff, with other job roles in between. Now, the rates of those disorders that staff are exhibiting in corrections are way higher, multiple times higher, than those in the general population, and even higher than those in first responders and military samples in some cases. So we have several trainings that we have designed in order to help prevent and also for staff to cope with corrections fatigue. I'll just share some with you. We have our signature course, From Corrections Fatigue to Fulfillment, which has been awarded the Commercial Product Award of Excellence in 2016 by ICTP, the International Association of Corrections Training Personnel. We have this course in 5 versions. The first 4 are 1 day long, and the last one is 4 hours long for staff at correctional institutions for adults, probation and parole agents and staff working in juvenile correctional institutions, and staff working with juveniles that are just as involved in the community. We additionally have True Grit, which is like the sequel to the Fatigue Fulfillment course, and it's about building resilience in staff and in different areas, and it's like a cookbook with a lot of different tools for the staff's toolbox. We have a peer support training. The correctional family wellness is for family members, whether they are members of veteran staff or if they're family members of brand new staff. And we have the supportive correctional supervisor, which is a very important course because research shows that supportive supervisors in general have a huge impact on staff's well-being, even all the way to their home life. And we have some books that reinforce the same points. Some are written by us, some are written by the correctional staff, and you can take them home and share with your family, educate them some about the kind of work you do. And our correctional oasis are monthly e-sign at no charge. You can subscribe to it on our site. It has some really, really good articles. And we look forward to hearing from you. Please contact us with questions, comments, feedback, input. We'd appreciate that, and we thank you for what you do.